We'll take a break, and after it, we feature the quite incredible performance by Leeds United. It's a high-scoring annihilation of a side that would appear in a quite different league from the Yorkshiremen. Luckless Southampton is on the receiving end, and that's in a couple of minutes. You were hot.
Well, I think it was Leeds hit the peak around that time from Christmas of 71 to 72. In fact, just around the end of 71, we went in a race for the championship. And the Southampton match you're going to show, Southampton actually beat us at the Dell. And that's when we started the run, because we weren't out of the, we weren't in the race, really. Yeah. We didn't look to be in the race. And Don Revie was a very intense type of man.
Yeah.
And he used to worry about the opposition a lot. But at that particular stage, from Christmas onwards, he said, look, just go out and play. And it released us a lot. Yeah. And I think we went into that run, Manchester United, Southampton, towards the end of the season. In fact, we should have won the double at the end of the season.
And the Leeds team, can you take us through it, Bobby?
Sure.
Well, it's actually probably as good a Leeds side as you would have ever seen. At fullback, Paul Reaney, Paul Madeley, really solid. Billy Bremner and Johnny Giles, two of the greatest midfield players that you could hope for. Our Jack at centre-half, tall, win everything in the air. Norman Hunter, midfield ball winner, tackler. Not a bad passer of the ball either. And up front, Alan Clark, Miggs Jones, Peter Lorimer, all goal scorers. And of course, Eddie Gray, very cultured Eddie Gray. Great left foot, wonderful dribbling ability, and a really, really strong outfit.
Tell us about the Southampton side then, Johnny.
Well, Southampton were going reasonably well at that time. A lot of tough players, Jimmy Gabriel, Jim Steele, very tough lads, Brian O'Neill, another one, and they had a young Mick Shannon coming into the side, and Ron Davis, who was a very, very good centre-forward, very good in the air, good side, and Southampton in those days were hard to beat at the Dell, and they were doing okay, always mid-table, get a good cup run, but not an easy team to beat. We beat them easy this particular day, but they weren't always such an easy team to beat.
So Leeds versus Southampton 1972, the year that the miners' strike began and industry went into a three-day week. Let's join it for the kick-off with Barry Davis in the commentary box.
Mick Jones, the Leeds number nine, all prepared to play his 300th league game, his 151st for Leeds United. Previously he played 149 for Sheffield United. And in fact, he needs three goals for his 50 for Leeds. Southampton in the stripes, playing right to left and with the wind behind them. It's been pouring with rain for the last 5 minutes, but fortunately it's just relented. Paul Madeley. Jones beaten by Steele. Two teams in identical positions from that match on March the 28th, 1970. Southampton in 18th place, Leeds second. Alan Clark. Hunter. Madeley, Gray on the touchline. It's Gray who started things against Manchester United. And everybody else joined in the act. O'Neill. Terry Payne. O'Neill, who came on as a substitute last week, must have one game in the reserves. Ron Davis. Turn creates a bit of space for himself. Shannon shot. Goal kick. Mick Shannon scored two fine goals the last time we saw him on television for the England under 23 team against the Scotland under 23 team at Derby. Good running across by Jones, found space for Lorimer. Clark is unmarked on the far side of the box, but it's too long. No, it's not. To Bremner. Forward for Gray again. Jones, Gray, Clark out to the left. In comes Clark!
He has a nicely worked goal, an early one too. Johnny?
Well, again, typical Alan Clark. He was good on both sides, very good strike of the ball on his right foot and left. A great movement up to a Billy starting it.
Yeah.
Eddie Gray, who was always capable of doing, beating somebody, opening up a little toe poke. Mick Jones, Sean and Alan Clark getting on the outside, Eddie putting them through. You see him on the left side, he's whacking it across the goalkeeper. I don't know, he might have got a little deflection off the defender coming in as well.
I don't know what Don Revie's saying, but he must have been getting a bit frustrated with Leeds with so much of the play, but they've waited until the 38th minute to score a goal. Stretching for it, Lorimer did very well, still doing well, no foul has been given, Lorimer protesting, the mutual scrambling and pushing and shoving, really left the referee with having to call it six of one, half a dozen of the other. Eddie Gray, Lorimer, lovely flick, Lorimer, not a good shot.
Yes, I mean, he's always had plenty of power, Lauren, hasn't he?
Yeah, one of the most powerful shots. But it was he had a great touch as well, Peter Lorimer. He wasn't just a lad that can hit them hard. And, I mean, he hit that in the right place, kept it down. Bit pacey as well, you see. He's not short of pace. There he goes.
Very underrated player, yeah. Peter. Peter had this reputation for having a great shot, which he was. And he had that label. But Peter could really play, made a lot of goals.
Oh, yeah.
And scored a lot of goals.
Yeah.
Stokes, Shannon. Southampton now have got to completely alter their tactics. They were giving all the impressions of playing for the draw. Away goes Lorimer. Clark and Jones to his left, and Bremner. In comes Clark, taken away from him by Martin. Break, wanting to go across and collect. Been a spectator except for one save. Clark, Lorimer. Might just have time. No, they won't. The only question of the half. But why we waited so long for the first goal, the answer might well be Jimmy Gabriel. But after 37 minutes of frustration for Leeds, Alan Clark scored in the 38th minute. And then Peter Lorimer followed it up with number two in the 41st.
Yes, just 2-0 at half-time, but what a second half you have coming up. I know that Johnny Giles and Bobby Charlton are looking forward to it. A welter of goals, so don't go away. Join us in just a couple of minutes.
It was all going so well.
He does put himself in there, Robbie L.
Chim!
Who scored the first of them, the far side of those three, John Giles, number 10, back to Jack Charlton. rain has gone away again, but the wind now blowing from behind Leeds United. Alan Clark beating the touchline. Lorimer. Steele, who made the tackle, lived up to his name then. Ron Davis. Surprised to see Hunter caught like that. Very rare moment. A little bit more of the soul shoe shuffle. Clark making a good run right to left. Jones now behind him on the touchline. The move into the middle is a bit slow though. Now Gray. Bremner. Jack Charlton coming up square. Two Southampton on one.
So 2-0 at half-time, John. What would Dunraven have said at half-time in the dressing room?
Well, if I can remember properly, I think we were well on top in the first half and we should have been more than two up.
Yeah.
And he said, like, it's no good playing all your good football if you don't score the goals. So I think he wanted us to have an end product of what we were doing.
Gray. Giles. Clark. The stripes are running around, but they're keeping it out of the moment. And they're forcing Leeds to play it along the line. Clark calling for it on the far side. Here's Lorimer. Oh, he's beaten him twice. Still got a chance to cross it. Gabriel's header. Clark. Gray on the right. Clark. Lorimer. Blocked by McCarthy. Two up for Southampton. Now three. With all the Leeds defences assembled. Giles. Bremner. Jones is left. Lorimer is right. Ron Davis. Shannon. Davis. The free kick given against Norman Hunter. Jimmy Gabriel's gone up on the near side as we look, wearing number five. There he is with Ron Davis. Gabriel now coming across the area, Davis coming in behind him, but the ball being held up a bit in the wind. Nice use of a stretch right leg. Gray. Jenkins. Shannon. Davis. Shannon a bit slow to get to his feet. Clark. Giles. That's for Lorimer. Nicely flighted. I suspect that might well have beaten Martin if it had been on target. Hunter just got a little touch on Davis's leg then. So much quicker.
And Johnny played quite a big part in that goal, didn't he?
Well, yeah, John was a great little passer of the ball, you know, and he slotted it through for Alan Clark. And whether it was on his right side or his left side didn't matter to him. He was a great striker. Could have taken on his right side, but decided his left. finds a little bit of space, time to look up. Classic finish, really. Mm.
Great. Out of the match, goal number three, and it won't be the finish. It didn't go. The linesman said it did, but I doubt very much if the whole of that ball crossed the line. Breaking into, we're going to win the league. You've got to believe us. From the evidence of what we've seen of Leeds in recent weeks, it doesn't take too much believing. People in Manchester City and Derby might have other thoughts, and elsewhere down in Highbury. Here's Mick Jones. Did he play the ball, the goalkeeper? Got to give him the benefit of the doubt. Here's Larimer. Clark. Jenkins. Giles. Free kick against Stokes. No, it's not given, but here's Larimer. And I think that must count as a no-goal.
Bit harsh, that.
Hardly a no-goal, John.
Oh, how cruel.
Hey? Yep. Let's see what happens. There we are, Johnny.
I think the defender had a lot to do to keep this out.
But apart from the goal, I mean, you are now 4-0 up and you're really motoring at this point, weren't you? I mean, you're really showing supreme form.
Yeah, well, I think the game as a contest was over at this particular stage. Because, you know, Bobby Italian in a tight game, no score, 1-0 down and 1-0 up.
You wouldn't take so many chances, maybe.
You wouldn't do the same things.
No.
But the game as a contest was over at that stage.
Yeah.
Scored five in a home match played away from home at the beginning of the season, and they beat Newcastle at Hillsborough. Here's O'Neill. Giles, Gray, Bremner, beaten by Gabriel. Giles has run round so well. Here's Bremner again. No, not a good one that time.
He's having a real ball, is Lorimer, isn't he, Johnny?
Yeah, well, Peter doesn't miss them from those positions. I think he's a powerful shot in his right foot, and when he gets it in this position, he scored loads of goals across the goalkeeper. As you were saying to Bobby early on, a long time he looked like he'd miskicked the ball a little bit, but he knew exactly what he was doing. He could kid the goalkeeper that was going to knock it in the near post and drag it across into the far corner.
And we're just noticing there's so much space behind the goal, Johnny. Why is that?
Well, they were doing... building work, they were building new stands, or plans to build new stands in those days, and then they moved the pitch forward, which left more room behind what they call the scratch and set, and they put the new stand up from there.
Oh, yeah.
717th all told for the club, and not one that either he or the club will want to remember very much. And that at the moment makes it Leeds' best victory at 5-0. Both Newcastle and Manchester United scored one. Jones, and the foul has been given. McCarthy. Bremner, Giles. Clark. Gonna go it alone. And he very nearly found the corner. Bremner, Lorimer, all the stripes coming out, Hunter's offside, he's got back now, play number six, Gray moving to the near post, Jack Charlton!
Well, Big Jack had quite a good scoring record as a centre-back, didn't he?
Yeah, he used to come up and stand near the goalkeeper,
yeah.
And any in-swinging corner kicks, well, any corner kicks really, is so big and tall, but good in the air. Yeah, he had a good record. I mean, I think on a regular basis over the years he scored at least 10 goals a season, I think.
Yeah. Towers up, doesn't he?
Showed Norman Hunter's skill there as well. Norman used to have the name being a hard man, but he had a terrific left foot as well, and that's him making the break and coming down the overlap and getting a beautiful cross in from there.
O'Neill for Southampton, Gabriel now up in attack. It doesn't seem to matter anymore. Hunter away. Here's McCarthy. Giles. Jenkins. Shannon. Gary's break, the coldest man around. Looks as they want to become an outfield player. Gray. Jack Charlton playing at right half. Charlton now playing it inside right, still waiting for the ball to come up to him. Some pressure. Steele, McCarthy to O'Neill. Jack Charlton had time to see whether O'Neill was hurt. Not a good return ball by Jones. Eric Martin, who conceded 8 at Goodison Park, 5 at home against Manchester United, now 6 here, and must wonder whether there's any more to come. Underneath it, in comes Jones!
Well, that really was a typical Leeds goal, wasn't it?
Well, there was a lot of passing in the build-up to it, and
Sean, great skill. Eddie Gray, beautiful cross. Peter Lomer knocking it. Eddie was great at that. He was very quick, big lad, but he was very quick. Beautiful left foot. You see the cross going right across the goal, and Peter picking him out. He only knows he's got to head it back as far as he can. Mick Jones following it up. When you're winning well, you're six up. It all becomes very easy at that stage.
Yes.
Leeds manager's face still not giving anything away. That Leeds are playing with Southampton is the understatement of the season. Poor Southampton just don't know what day it is. Every man jack of this Leeds side is now turning it on. Oh, look at that! It's almost cruel. The Allen Road crowd are lapping it up. Second home match running, Leeds United are turning on a brilliant show, and the other team are just not on the park. Even when a pass goes astray, they can pick it up. Got to feel some sympathy for Southampton. The gap between their position and Leeds is an almighty chasm. Jack Charlton is miles offside forward, that's why Lorimer's holding it. Massacre it looks on paper, and a massacre it was. Credit Southampton with taking defeat gracefully, but really they were in a different league from Leeds United, who totally